لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So the Hajj journey itself is actually 5 or 6 days. And even though the days actually start in the month of Dhul-Hijjah, the first actual day of Hajj is on the 8th day, the 8th of Dhul-Hijjah. So what happens is on the 8th of Dhul-Hijjah, 2 days before the day of Eid, the pilgrims, the people who've gone for Hajj, they'll put themselves in what's called a state of Ihram. Now Ihram for men is they're going to be actually wearing these two white garments, and for women they retain their garments. So Ihram is not actually the clothing that you wear. Ihram is actually a state of mind and a state of spiritual consciousness that you actually have. That's what Ihram really is. So for men and women both, they're going to kind of trim their unwanted body hair. They're going to maybe put a little perfume on their body, not on their clothes, but on their body. And then for men, they're going to remove their clothing and they're only going to wear one waist wrapper, like a loincloth, and they're going to wear one garment on top. And usually these are preferred to be white, almost look like towels. You're not supposed to be wearing during the time of Ihram any clothing that is stitched. So if you have a shirt which wraps around you, it has to be stitched in order to stay in place. Even the openings need to be stitched a little bit so that it's cut in a specific way. These are the simplest garments that you could possibly have. And what that's signifying, the simplicity that Islam actually wants us to have in our life. We can wear stitched clothing, we can have some nice meals, we can do certain things, but this is a reminder about what human beings essentially are, that they should not become extravagant. They should not go above and beyond and just focusing on luxuries in this life. And by getting into this state of Ihram, that reminds them that, you know what, this is the state of a human being. We should not go to excess and we can survive. We can live with this humility. And when we approach God, we approach Allah with a sense of humility as well. So that's for men. For women, there's an exemption. If women were to wear the same clothes, there'd be too many revealing parts of the body. So they have an exemption on the clothing, but they are supposed to follow the other requirements that men and women both observe. And that is not cutting any hair from the body, not plucking, not cutting, not trimming any part of the hair, and not applying any type of perfume on to make yourself smell good. Now this is interesting. Because in Islam, normally you're supposed to smell good. You're supposed to try and decorate yourself. You're supposed to do all of these things. But in Hajj, we learn to practice the utmost level of humility, the utmost level of simplicity for only these few days. So what's going to happen is a pilgrim is going to put on their clothing that they need, make sure to avoid the things that they're not supposed to do. They're in a state of Ihram. Once they enter into the state of Ihram, they head towards a region which is an open field, an open region called Mina. And this is where the people of Hajj are going to be spending most of their days during the Hajj journey. And Mina is special because Prophet Ibrahim, when he was ordered by Allah to sacrifice his son as a test, this is where he was being tempted by Satan, telling him not to listen to this. Don't do what Allah is telling you to do. And he threw some stones to try and just chase away these whisperings that were coming to him. And that's why this place is special. And this place is also special because the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, this is where he stopped during his Hajj journey. So what's going to happen in the day of Mina, on the 8th day of Dhul-Hijjah, people will put them into a state of Ihram, begin to chant and say, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik, which means, O Allah, here I am. I have answered your call and I am here because you called me to do this pilgrimage and come for Hajj. So we do that, we go to Mina, and in the 8th day, the only thing we do is we stay at Mina in our tents. It's very hot usually, it's open field. You sit in your tent, you remember Allah, you read Quran, you pray. But the last thing that's really interesting about while you're doing the Hajj and while you're at Mina, you're going to be shortening your prayers. So your 4-unit prayers of Dhuhr prayer, Asr prayer, Isha prayer, they're all going to be shortened to 2 units instead. So it's as if you're traveling, even though you're not really traveling, but because there's some difficulty on this journey,
we're actually allowed to shorten our prayers. So that's a thing that we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for as well, for making our lives not overly burdensome. Even though we have to wear a certain type of clothing, even though we have to refrain from certain things which may be a little bit uncomfortable. The clothing that we're going to be wearing during this time, especially for men, it's not very comfortable at all. But we're doing it out of dedication to God. And at the same time, He does not overburden us by making us do more things which are extremely difficult for us, and we even get to shorten our prayers. So this is kind of the beginning, the start of Hajj, where we start on the 8th day of Dhul-Hijjah, just spending the entire night at Mina, relaxing and praying.